Yes, that's the key. Be in the kingdom. Let your light shine before men, and they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Amen. Thank you, First Lady. Don't she look beautiful? All right. Pastor Devin, we are going up. We certainly do thank God for the service this morning. Any more prayer requests?
Hearts, Lord, and minds to be saved in the mighty name of Jesus. Remember the body of Christ everywhere, Lord. Bless our leaders in Jesus' mighty name. Strengthen them, Lord, and bless them, Lord Jesus. Look on our bishop here today, Lord. Asking that you strengthen him, Lord. We know that he's tired in his body. Asking that you bless him, Lord, in his body. And Lord, grant him the door of utterance today. Send us a word from heaven and bless him, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. We ask that you'll bless our service and help us, Lord, to lift up and magnify your name, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. But we realize that you're worthy, Lord, of all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. These blessings we ask in your Son, Jesus' name, and for Christ's sake. Let us all say together, amen. Turn with me to the book of the 8th division of Psalms. Psalms 8. Everybody have to say amen.
Oh,
We owe God a praise. Amen. He woke us up this morning, started us on our way. And for that, we're grateful. Amen. Amen. Who will be the first one to give God praise? Sister Cora.
I thank God for the
Because God will give you what you want. But sometimes it'll be a very big headache to you, amen? So you have to tell him, not my will, but thy will. Because he knows what's best for us, amen? Amen. Right now we're going to change the order of our service, amen? We're going to, Sister Corey, would you like to come up and do the announcements?
No announcements.
Alright, just Bible study, Wednesday night, 6 o'clock. Amen. I'm looking at your job.
Hold on for a minute. We said just Bible study. I said that too. It's Bible study.
Alright, it's Bible study. Amen. Wednesday night, 6 p.m. Amen. And it is truly Bible study because the pastor digs deep and God gives us new revelations and we enjoy Bible class. Amen. It's a school of higher learning too, amen?
Amen. And
Friday night prayer, amen? 6 o'clock, amen?
Yes.
All right, then you know Sunday morning service starts at 11 a.m. Well, Sunday school at 9:30, and Sunday morning service at 11 a.m., amen? Amen. All right, we're going to have Deacon Fields come up and lift our morning's offering for us, amen? Thank you, Jesus.
We thank God and praise God. grace and mercy that He has shown toward us. Amen. And I can truly say I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord.
Yes.
The Bible says for us to enter in His gates with thanksgiving and to enter in His courts with praise.
Amen.
And it's truly a good time to praise God. It's something that Pastor Doug said, you praise Him when you feel like it, you praise Him when you don't feel like it. Those are the two times that you ought to praise God. And having said that, anytime that we should always offer up God a sacrifice. Amen. And when your body's tired and you still praise Him, that's a sacrifice. Amen. And God honors that sacrifice. Because if you're just a fair weather friend, you know, that don't move God. What moves God is your dedication, your steadfastness, your unmovableness. That's what moves God. So we thank God for you being here on today. Give God a praise. And we certainly do thank God for all of those that, in Christian ministries that served that great funeral for our brother Terrell Bennett. And we give God a praise. Not only during the funeral, but to getting the building for prayer, making things ready, those that were cooking and cleaning, and those that were praying and encouraging and directing, and those that were here in the worship service, worshiping and praising God and comforting the family from A to Z. And you know, from A to Z, truly it takes a village, it takes a people to help others. No man is an island. Amen? We all need one another. We're all codependent in some way. So we certainly do thank God and praise God for that. And we also thank and praise God for just being who He is. Amen. Who He is, our strength and our shield and our buckler. Amen. We want to thank God for our musicians. I wish I could keep here tonight, today. But our musicians are coming. Thank you, Lord. And we certainly do praise God for that. Pray for those that might be not only traveling now over the highways and the byways to get back to their several abodes, but also pray for those that will be traveling, that the Lord will continue to bless. I have my cousin Sheila here, all the way from California. Pray for her daughter Patrice. Amen. That the Lord will continue to touch her and bless her. And you got more encouraging news on today? I believe I'm still the same. Oh, okay. All right. That is 3 hours difference in it. Yes. Amen. So let us pray for her daughter, that the Lord will touch her body. And I know that I thought about you, I think it was yesterday, could have been today. My mind's just like a little jello right now. But I thought about you, I said, man, she you know, come and spend time with the family, and, you know, she got things going on, and I know you just want to be free, you know what I mean, to enjoy yourself. But we certainly do trust God and believe that God can do all things. Amen? Thank you, Jesus. And we certainly do thank and praise God for Christian ministries. And I praise God for each and every one of you. Amen? Thank God for my wife and first lady, Pastor Doug. Thank you, all of you that have come, amen, to be with us on today. As I said, let me turn to a verse of scripture out of the book of St. James. A verse of scripture out of the book of St. James. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. We certainly do praise God. Pray for those over there that are going to head back to Pittsburgh area. And the Lord will bless them from St. James. Cleveland, Ohio peoples. Amen. Those are Florence children, and the Elias children back there. They didn't grow up on us. Thank you, Lord. Let us pray for them. Samantha, she didn't have the baby. Who did she have? A baby girl. Amen. I got a proud pocket out there. And what's the baby's name? Say again?
Lyrica
Reagan Clark. All right. I thought she was going to slip Susie in. Six times exactly. Amen. Y'all know, y'all remember she had testified one time and said she was only 3 times. She was on purpose. But you know, God has a way. God has a way. So we thank God for addition to the family. Anytime in mom's home. Amen. We certainly do thank God for that. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. God is good. Amen. And won't you just stand with me just for a moment? Thank you, Jesus. Looking at James chapter number 4, James is a critical individual, and he doesn't mince words. He comes right out to the point. James chapter number 4, and I just want one verse of scripture from that particular verse. Actually, I want two, just because they kind of go together. 4:1, it says, "From whence cometh wars and fighting among you? Cometh they not hence, even of your lusts that war in your members?" And drop down to verse number 7. That's our scriptural text for today. It says, "Submit yourselves, therefore, to God. Resist the devil, and he shall flee from you." Submit yourselves to God. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Oh, gracious Father, in the name of Jesus, we certainly thank you, Lord, for your anointing. We thank you, Lord, for your gracious mercy, your strength, and your power. We ask you, Lord, that you allow your anointing to rest on us on this day. We are gathered together here, Lord, to hear a word from you. Lord, we ask you to speak a word to these great people. Open up our understanding. Use us to your glory. Open up their ears that they may receive of thy greatness and of thy word, that they may grow thereby. Father, we thank you and praise you. Give you glory and honor. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. And I just want to literally take for a thought this morning. Submit to God and resist the devil. Submit to God and resist the devil. And as we were, for the past 3 weeks, if you've been tuning in or if you've been here and paying attention, we've been really talking about prayer. And God really wants us to engage in prayer. We have a saying that we say, and it's true, God, prayer changes things. Prayer is the very foundation of receiving anything from God. If we were to get theological and get deep on you on today, that you have to remember that when God made man, he gave man dominion over this earth. He gave us dominion over this earth. And he put that us in charge of things on this earth. And when we pray asking God, giving God permission to operate on our behalf. Because God has given us dominion. And He wants to be involved in our lives, but God does not overrule us. So we have to pray and seek God to give him permission to operate and to move upon us. And when we don't pray and ask God, it's like go God. You want God on your side. That's why we have to ask. The Bible says, ask, and it shall be given. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and the door shall be opened. Because God is a gentleman, if you allow me to say it, and he doesn't violate your will. So we have to give God permission to operate and to move on our behalf. And God is more than willing and able to operate on our behalf if we ask, if we seek, if we knock. And as we were talking about a couple weeks and into our prayer, we learned that the Bible says that we ought to come boldly to the throne of grace, that we might obtain mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need. And that's one type of prayer. That's one type of prayer that you can come and approach God at any time because the way has been made. The scripture says that we have a great high priest, and his name is Jesus, that can be touched with the feelings of our infirmities. He knows our weakness, and he's there to help us and to aid us in our time of need. And we preach from a subject, don't forsake your help. Don't forsake your help. We need help. I don't know about you, but I need some help. So it's available unto you to receive help from God. All you got to do is come boldly to God's throne of grace. And then that's a type of prayer. That's another type of prayer that God has given us access to, because there's more than one or two or three types of prayer. Depends on what type of situation you're in, and that gives you a clue on how to pray. There's another type of prayer that when you're facing an unjust situation, when you're facing an unjust adversary, and that adversary is bothering you. And the Bible says that you ought to come to God with a prevailing type of prayer, that you want God to avenge you of your adversary, that there's some bullies out there that's trying to kick you around. There's some situations that are going on that you want to get a handle on, and you want God to fight your battle. Then you come to God in a type of way like Jacob came to God when he was dealing with his brother Esau that wanted to get him. And Jacob was a little bit nervous about approaching his brother because he had did his brother dirty about 10 years earlier. But God had a plan. God had a mission for him, and he had to go back to the land of Israel and be a prince and be a ruler and make part of a mini nation. But he had some apprehensions about going back because he looked at Esau, his brother, as being an enemy. And the Bible says that before he was to approach Esau, that he had a dream. And in that dream, he saw heaven open and the angels descending and ascending upon a ladder. And as he was praying, he was asking God to help him. And then daybreak was coming. And the Bible says that the angel said that I got to go because daybreak is coming. And Esau and Jacob held on to him and said, I won't let you go until you bless me. I won't let you go until you bless me. And that's a type of prayer that we have to have with God if we're serious about overcoming issues and serious about overcoming situations. We got to stay on our knees and seek after God until he blesses us, until he opens up a door. And the angel said that he was going to bless him in the hollow of his thigh. That's a whole nother sermon, and changed his name from Jacob to Israel because he literally prevailed with God. You can prevail with God in prayer. You can prevail with God in prayer. If you're serious about your prayer life and you're serious about mountains moving, you can pray until the earth moves. You can pray until the jailhouse opens. You can pray until you get an answer. You can pray until you shut the mouth of the gainsayer. You can pray until situations change on your behalf. You can pray until you gain your favor with God. Amen. Until you gain your favor with God.
Yeah.
That's another type of prayer. And there's another type of prayer that we should always be mindful of us. The Bible says that men should always pray and not faint. And that type of prayer, you're just constantly in a prayer mode. You're instant in prayer. When you're walking around, you're just praying in your mind for the peace of God and for the grace of God and for the anointing of God. And when people come up on your mind, you're praying for them throughout the day. You're praying for this brother, for this sister. You may see a situation, an ambulance going down the street, and you start praying, Lord, bless them and keep them and watch over them. Do y'all pray like that? Do y'all pray like that throughout the day? That's another type of prayer. God wants you to be instant in season and out of season, and keep a prayer mode in your life so that when situations arise, you know what to do. You know to pray. You know to ask God to intervene. You know to ask God to come on in. Do y'all pray like that? Y'all got a mind like that? You just walk around just instant in prayer. You got your mind stayed on Jesus. The Bible says that he'll keep thee in perfect peace if you keep your mind stayed in. Do I got people praying for me right now? You pray, or you just walk past the queen just to hurry up so you can move on. That the anointing will fall, that people are getting healed, that people are getting delivered.
Yeah.
My God, we got to be in that kind of instant mode of prayer. That's what the Bible means when it says, pray without ceasing.
Yeah.
Pray without ceasing. You just got your mind stayed on Jesus all the time. You got to train your mind to stay on Jesus, because that's not a natural thing. It's not an automatic thing. You got to keep your mind stayed on him. And if you keep your mind stayed on him, you'll be in perfect peace. The enemy can't catch you off guard if you keep your mind stayed on him. It's like people that don't keep their mind stayed on him, and when they fasted, when food set afore them, they'll start eating, and they go, oh, man, I'm on a fast. Thank God, I shouldn't be eating right now. Then you want to pray and ask God to forgive you. But you got to realize the reason why you ain't that food, because you didn't have your mind. You didn't have your mind stayed on him. And that's how the enemy sneaks up on us, when we ain't got our mind stayed on the Lord. And if you got an instant prayer, that's what the Bible says. Be instant in season and instant out of season with prayer. You got to have that kind of mold in your mind of prayer. My God, man. We've got to realize that there are many forms of prayer, and you've got to figure out what kind of prayer to use in your situation. You can't be a handyman and all you got is a screwdriver, and everything you look at is a screw. Hallelujah. But you need a different tool to get the job done. And that's the same way with God. There are different prayers that you need to know how to pray to get the job done. Amen. It's a different way, because life, as our brother, thank you, Lord, once said, that it's like a box of chocolate. Amen. It's variety in life. So you got to know how to pray, because you got to know that there's different varieties in life. And when you know how to pray and seek God, you'll get your answer. So that brings us to our text here on today. My God, y'all just give me just a few more minutes. That brings us here to our text on today. James, in chapter number 4 and verse number 1, he's asking a question. He says, whence cometh wars and fighting among you? Come they not hence, even of your own lust, that war in your members? What James is offering up for us on today, as we begin to go into the scriptures, and the Bible says that James said in that third verse, he said that ye ask and ye receive not, because ye ask amiss, that ye may consume things upon your own lust. And brothers and sisters, that this is true in our lives, because we all have dreams and aspirations. We all want to accomplish accomplish things, and we all want God to make us prosperous. We want God to move on our behalf. And you know, God's timing is not our timing. God's place and God's plans are not our plans. The Bible says that His ways are not our ways, and His thoughts are not our thoughts, and His ways are past finding out. So sometimes we ourselves, we get in a hurry. We want God to bless us our way. Sometimes you get it in your mind that I'm going to do A, B, and C, and D to make things happen for my life. Not realizing that that's not God's way. And when you get to do things your way and not acknowledge God in His way for your life, you run into conflict. You run into problems, especially if you're calling yourself a child of God. My God, the Bible says that God resists the proud, but He gives grace unto the humble. Yeah. So when you're asking things just because of your desires and because you want it to happen, your motive is not right. If you're asking God for things because you want to consume it upon your own lust, not really considering your brother or your sister, not really considering the totality of your decisions, but you want it just to make your own self prosperous. You want it because you want to look good. You want to keep up with the Joneses, my God. Who am I talking here today? Hallelujah. That's when the Bible says there are wars and fighting, because within your own self, there's a war going on. You want to do it one way, but God wants you to do it another way. The Bible says that it tells us that I would do good, but evil is always present with me. My God, and that evil ain't always the devil coming up against you, but that evil could be your own thoughts and your own desires and your own wishes and your own dreams. And those dreams and those thoughts don't line up with God. You've got to make up in your mind that I'm going to walk with God. I'm going to live for Him. You've got to make up in your mind that God be true and every man a liar. And that's what James is saying. He's saying that when you're warring with yourself and the devil is trying to promote you, the devil is trying to give you all kind of thoughts. He's trying to tell you which way to go. He's trying to give you information. The Bible says and it tells us that we've got to walk in the counsel of the ungodly. We've got to resist those that are giving us information and they don't live for God. We've got to resist those that don't have God on their menu. God is not at their table, but yet they want to give us information. And the Bible says don't walk in their counsel, because they're walking out in the counsel of God. Don't stand in the way of sinners. Don't sin at the seat of the scornful. But you've got to allow your delight, your happiness, and your joy to come from the law of the Lord. And in God's law, the Bible says, you've got to meditate in it day and night. Then you'll be like that tree that is planted by the rivers of water. My God, and when you ask God to bless you, the Bible says, then ye shall prosper. Why? Because you're not asking amiss, you're asking it according to the will of God. It's important that you ask according to God's will. It's important that you seek God's face. And that right early, it's important that you put God first, because if God be for you, then we then can be against you. If God is on your side, that's when all things work together for good to them that love God, to them that are being called according to His purpose. And when you understand that particular verse, you understand that there's situations out there, there's people out there that are trying to get you. You gotta realize that there's people out there that are not for you, but whatever they do to you because you are a friend of God, it's working for your good. Because God is able to turn it around. God is able to put you in their head. Hallelujah. Move you to the front where everybody's trying to hold you down. You want to clap your hands and give God praise? You want to magnify God?
under control. And if you don't keep your flesh under control, you'll spun off in a moment. You'll cuss somebody out. You'll tell somebody off. I mean, that's the James was saying. That if you try to push yourself ahead, you're going to have some trouble. Dear, the devil is always trying to hijack the process of God. My God, God has a process. God has a way. My God, God, you got to get into God's way. You got to get into God's process and let things happen according to the will of God. That's what the devil did when Jesus went up into the mountain to pray. The Bible says that when Jesus went there to pray, he prayed and he fasted for 40 days and 40 nights. My God, and the Bible says that afterward, he was a hunger. My God, and after his praying and his fasting, the devil came to him and wanted Jesus to hijack the process and said, if thou be the Son of God, make these stones bread. Hallelujah, Jesus, because he was full of the Holy Ghost and he realized who he was and whose he was. He said, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. But the devil wasn't done. The devil wasn't done. The devil took him to a pinnacle of a high mountain and told him to jump down from this mountain. At least the angels bury him. And Jesus, because he was anointed, because Jesus was suffering himself. The Bible says he was obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Hallelujah. He told the devil, my God, that man shall not tempt the Lord thy God. Hallelujah. And that's when he realized that people shouldn't tempt God. You shouldn't tempt God. You should put plans ahead of God and think that God is going to move on your behalf and catch you anyhow. My God, and then the devil, he left him and showed him that all the kingdoms of this world. And he said, if you bow down before me, my God, I'll give him to you. My Lord, and Jesus told the devil, my God, that this thing that you're trying to give me, it doesn't belong to you, but it belongs to God. And that's how you got to see that the devil is always trying to hijack the process of God. God, the devil is always trying to move you ahead. But if you trust in the devil is going to leave you open. He's going to leave you naked. Because then you've got to realize that the devil's mission has never changed. It's to kill, it's to steal, and it's to destroy. Whatever the devil offers, my God, you've got to realize that. You've got to resist it. Because what the devil offers, it don't mean you no good. And the devil works through people, hallelujah, to bring you what you don't need. That's why the Bible says, resist the devil and he shall flee. Oh my God, whatever the devil is offering you, you gotta submit to the will of God and resist the devil. And that's the type of prayer. If you're going through and you know that the enemy is offering you some things, hallelujah, and you know that what he's offering you is not from God, you've got to get down on your knees and you've got to pray. You've got to pray and resist that devil. You've got to resist that devil. Hallelujah. You've got to resist those desires. You've got to resist that which the enemy is trying to kill unto you, because he's trying to hijack the plan of God. The devil is trying to destroy you. The devil is trying to bring you to a position where you'll be no influence. You'll be like the salt without its savior. You'll be good for nothing but to be trapped out and trodden under the foot of men. But brothers and sisters, I know you're hearing me here today. Hallelujah. But if you put your trust in the Lord, if you put your trust in the Lord and you submit unto the Lord will exalt you. The Lord wants to elevate you. You've got to realize that when you trust in God, you've got to let your light shine before men. Hallelujah. That they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. You've got to clap your hands and give God praise. trust in God and you believe in God, every step you make toward God, God will make two steps toward you. Oh my God, I believe you've got to realize that every battle that we win over here in this land is because we win it upon our knees. We win it because we're calling out to God, because God has to get the glory. If God is not getting the glory, hallelujah, then what we're doing is in vain. God has to get the glory out of every decision. God has to get the glory out of every condition. God has to get the glory out of every battle, out of every fight. So God is calling upon you to submit yourself unto Him, and He will exalt you. Come on and give God a praise. Come on and give God a praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. When the Bible tells us about Jesus, it tells us, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but found himself in the fashion as we are, the fashion of a man. And notice, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. We've got to humble ourselves and become obedient unto God. The way to humble yourself and become obedient unto death, you got to pray. You got to have a prayer life. You got to seek God and Him that by earth. You can't allow yourself to be fooled, thinking that you can serve God without prayer. When you search the scriptures and get to know and embrace even the gospels of Jesus Christ, Jesus prayed a great while before death. Even when Jesus got ready to raise Lazarus from the grave, he prayed. He said, Father, I know you hear me because I always do the things that you say. And then he prayed. He said, Father, allow what is going to happen to be glorified, that they may believe that I am the Christ, the Son of God. Jesus prayed. Lifestyle of prayer. When they came to him in the garden, Garden of Gethsemane, just before they were getting ready to take him to Calvary's mountain, Jesus was praying. The Bible says he prayed. He prayed until sweat ran down his face like great drops of blood. And he was struggling in his prayer. This is the kind of prayer that James was talking about, submitting oneself to God. He said, Father, if there be any other way, remove this cup. Jesus didn't want to die. He didn't want to go through that crucifixion. Hallelujah. But he said, Father, if it be any other way, nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done. This is the type of prayer that James is talking about. A nevertheless prayer. You know that God has an assignment for you. You know that God has a will for you. But you want to do it another way. You've got to come before God in your Garden of Gethsemane and say, God, hey, hallelujah, not my will, but thy will be done. Hallelujah. Not my will, but my will be done. These are the types of prayer that will get you over the hump. These are the types of prayer that will get you deliverance. These are the types of prayer that will get you a breakthrough. If you humble yourself beneath the mighty hand of God, God will exalt you. God will get the glory. God will be magnified. And because the battle doesn't belong to you, but the battle belongs to the Lord. And if God be for you, who then can be against you? But here's the war. Here's the battle. I want it my way. I got that Burger King. Man. have two masters. Yourself is a master. And serve God. You can't have it that way. And that's what James is after. He said, you ask, but you ask amiss. Why? Your motives are wrong. When you're asking God and seeking God in prayer, your motives have to be right. And you know, what you're asking for, I'm going to try to hear you. What you're asking for, it may be according to God's will, but the reason why you want it is wrong. And God will delay in blessing you until you get your motive right. Till you get your attitude right. An attitude with God is everything. God judges the heart. Man looks on the outward appearance, but God judges the heart. And you got to realize with God, all things are open. All things are naked with him from whom we have to do.
Yes, sir.
I'm trying to help somebody here. You want from God. God wants you to have. But how's your attitude? How's your motive? Why do you want it? Why do you want it? You want a car. God give you a Pinto. You say, God, I want a Pinto. I want a Cadillac. But won't the Pinto get you the way you're going? Hallelujah. Come on here, somebody. Huh? See, that's the war. That's the war. That's the fight. One of my children, I'm going to drive my car and wreck it. Wrecked it good in the front. Still driving. I said, hey, okay, drive the car so-and-so and pick up such-and-such. I won't drive that car. You don't you see it's all jacked up in the front? You jacked it up in the front. See, that's our fault. That's our fault.
Yeah.
I don't want to drive. That's how we get with God sometimes. God, I want you to bless me, but I want the house on the hill.
Yeah.
Maybe you ain't got it for the house on the hill. You gotta wait. You gotta go through the process. Come on here, somebody. You gotta go through the process. And if you go through the process with the right attitude, that's when God exalts you. That's when God lifts you up. That's when God can trust you. Oh, that's when God can magnify you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Gotta go through the right way. You get it too early, you be like Nebuchadnezzar. This is what I have done. Yeah, you won't say, the Lord bless me. We got to be careful. That's why he takes us through the process.
Amen?
Submit yourself to God. Let God humble you. And if your answer is delayed, question yourself. Lord, is my desire right? Is my attitude right? Don't give up. God don't want you to give up and say, oh, well, forget about it. Huh? If you got a legitimate request before God, don't give up on the request. Seek God. Question yourself. Is my attitude right? Am I asking why? Is this the right purpose? Is this the right reason? Hey, Lord. Hallelujah. And then while you're in prayer seeking him, he'll give you some corrective measures. And when he gives you some corrective measures, you follow the pattern. You humble yourself. You submit yourself. You line up with God and say, who am I talking to? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We thank God for this anointed word that he has put upon us. Thank you, Jesus. And we thank God for how he's blessing us. Come on and give God a praise. Thank you, Jesus.
Let the church stand. I'm going to trust in
the Lord.
Oh, yes.
I'm going to trust in the Lord.
We thank our viewers for viewing with us on today. We praise God for each and every one of you. And you can hear on our tablet to sow seed into the kingdom of God. Just like the Christian Ministries of the Apostolic. And truly be blessed. In the Lord.
Glory both now and forever. In Jesus' name, amen.